Hi my dear students, myself Kedarnath. Welcome to my channel Make Mathematics Simple. So in this session I am going to explain some miscellaneous series problems in binomial theorem. So look at the important result. So based upon this result I am going to prove some more results. Okay, so the result is C naught into CR. So CR is nothing but here NCR. Okay, so that means you have to read it as NC0 into NCR. You have to understand this first term as NC0 into NCR, okay? Second term NC1 into NCR plus 1 and so on. Cn minus r into Cn. What is its value? 2nc n plus r, which is same as 2nc n minus r, okay? Using NCR is equal to nc n minus r. So 2nc n plus r is same as 2nc 2n minus of n plus r, that is equal to n minus r, okay? So how we can prove this result? For that, you consider the multiplication of x plus 1 whole power n into 1 plus x whole power n. So the first bracket is expansion of x plus 1 whole power n. Second bracket terms are, they are the terms in the expansion of 1 plus x whole power n. So if you multiply these two, okay, if you multiply these two, so what you are getting? Polynomial. Here also if you multiply these two, what you are getting? Some polynomial only, no? So LHS polynomial is equal to RHS polynomial. LHS polynomial is equal to RHS polynomial. So as those two polynomials are equal, then corresponding coefficients also equal. Correct? So here I am doing what? To get this result. To get this result, I am equating coefficient of x power n plus r on both sides. So how we come to know that is we have to equate coefficient of x power n plus r only. See here, first term what we have? C naught into CR. Here C naught is what? C naught into x power n. Here CR into x power r is there. If you multiply these two terms, what you are getting? C naught CR into x power n plus r. Correct? Next C1 CR plus 1. See if you multiply this term and this term, what you are getting? C1 into CR plus 1, x power n minus 1 to x power r plus 1, again what you are getting? X power n plus r. That means, in this product, this LHS series is nothing but, that is the coefficient of x power n plus r. So that is why, to get that result, I am equating both sides by what? Coefficient of n plus r. Coefficient of x power n plus r. In RHS, it is clear that, okay, in RHS, okay, in this product, okay, in RHS product, okay, coefficient of x power n plus r is clear that C naught into CR plus C1 into CR plus 1 plus C2 into CR plus 2 plus and so on Cn minus r into Cn. Okay, now you have to find coefficient of x power n plus r in LHS. Okay, but what is LHS? We have x plus 1 whole power n into 1 plus x whole power n. So x plus 1 whole power n is same as 1 plus x whole power n only, na? So on multiplying these two, what we can write? That can be written as 1 plus x whole power 2n. Okay, now 1 plus x whole power 2n. In this expansion, what is the coefficient of x power n plus r? 2n c n plus r. Am I correct? Because the general term in this 1 plus x whole power n will be what? So 2n c r into x power r only. That means in the expansion of 1 plus x whole power 2n, so general term is what? 2n c r into x power r. That means the coefficient of x power r is what? 2n c r. So in the same way, what is the coefficient of x power n plus r in 1 plus x whole power 2n? 2n c n plus r. So thus in LHS, coefficient of x power n plus r is 2n c n plus r. In RHS product, the coefficient of n plus r is c naught cr, c1 cr plus 1, c2 cr plus 2 and so on cn minus r cn. As these two LHS and RHS are equal, automatically this series value should be equal to what? 2n c n plus r, which is same as 2n c n minus r. Okay. Now, if you put r value 0, here, if you put r value 0, you will get one interesting result. So, what is that result? If you put r value 0, Okay, then you will get what? C0 into C0. C0 into C0, C0 square. Plus C1 into C1, C1 square. Next, C2 into C2, C2 square. Plus and so on. Plus Cn square. Is equal, if you put r value 0, what you will get? 2nCn. So, it is the same as coefficient of x power n in 1 plus x whole power 2n. Okay? So, if you want to get direct result, you consider same way just like above problem. So, there what I did, I compare coefficient of x power n plus r to get this result. So, to get this result, what you have to compare or what you have to equate coefficient of x power n. Then RHS product, in RHS product, this is the coefficient of x power n. In LHS, this is the x coefficient of x power n. Okay, so that is equal to, that is same as 1 into 3 into 5 into 7 into and so on, 2n minus 1 divided by n factorial into 2 power n. Okay, remember, because once they asked this problem, okay, so that's why I'm giving different options. Okay, so the question is, what is the coefficient of x power n in 1 plus x whole power 2n? So first option is given 2ncn, second option is given c0 square plus c1 square plus c2 square and so on cn square, third option is given this, and fourth option is given all of this. So you have to choose what? All of these. Okay, now next result. So put r value 1, put r value 1, then what do you get the result? C0 C1 plus C1 C2 plus C2 C3 and so on Cn minus 1 into Cn is equal to what you get? 2n Cn plus 1, which is same as 2n Cn minus 1. Okay, so try to remember these two results, and I'm going to prove one more result also. So that one more result is A into C0 square plus A plus D into C1 square plus A plus 2D into C2 square plus and so on plus A plus ND into CN square. It is equal to what? Here if you observe C0 square, C1 square, C2 square coefficients, what? A plus D, A plus 2D, they are forming what? Arithmetic progression. So then how to remember this result means? So what is the coefficient of C0 square? A. Coefficient of Cn square, A plus ND. So first you find arithmetic mean of these two numbers. Then what do you get? A plus ND divided by 2 into what is the sum of C0 square plus C1 square plus C2 square and so on Cn square. That is nothing but sum of the squares of the binomial coefficients of order n. Sum of the squares of the binomial coefficients of order n. What do we have? 2n Cn. So thus the answer is 1 by 2 into 2a plus nd into 2n Cn. 2n Cn. Arithmetic mean of first and last. Okay. So first term coefficient A, last term coefficient A plus ND. Arithmetic mean will be what? A plus ND by 2. That is 2A plus ND by 2. Into sum of the sum of the C0 square, C1 square, C2 square and so on. Cn square is what? 2N Cn. Okay. Suppose if it is alternative is there. This one only. This question only. Here if it is alternative is there. So what is the answer? Okay. So, it is total positive series is there, the answer is what? 2n Cn. Alternative series is there, that is C0 square minus C1 square plus C2 square minus C3 square and so on minus 1 whole power n into Cn square. So, here we have two cases. So, here it is, this value is depending on n value. So, this value is equal to 0 if n is odd number, n is odd number. And its value is a minus 1 whole power n by 2 into ncn by 2 when n is even. Okay. So these are the some important results. So look at some examples. So what is a 15 c naught square minus 15 c1 square plus 15 c2 square and so on minus 15 c15 square? Here it is look like the above formula only, no? So instead of n, what we have? 15. So that n value 15 is even or odd number? Odd number. So thus this whole sum becomes what? 0. Okay, so take one more example. Suppose 16 c naught whole square minus 16 c1 whole square plus 16 c2 whole square and so on. Last term will be what? Plus or minus? Plus only, no? Minus 1 whole power n. That is minus 1 whole power 16 is minus 1. 16 c 16 whole square. So what is this value? Here n value how much? 16, which is even number. So what is the formula? Minus 1 whole power n by 2. That is minus 1 whole power 16 by 2 is 8 into n c n by 2. N is 16, c n by 2 is 8. Minus 1 whole power 8 is 1. So thus the answer is 16 c 8. Okay. So consider one more example. Suppose 1 into 15c0 plus 15c0 whole square plus 3 into 15c1 whole square plus 2, 5 into 15c2 whole square plus and so on. Total how many terms will get? Last term will be what, Nana? 15c15 whole square. And what will be its coefficient? So its coefficient should be what? So its coefficient should be 31. Correct? Its coefficient should be what? 31. Okay. So what is its value? So if you observe here, this 1, 3, 5 and so on, 31, they are forming what? Arithmetic progression only, no? Okay. And here what we have? C naught square. It is look like what? A into C naught square plus A plus D into C1 square plus A plus 2D into C2 square and so on. A plus ND into Cn square. So what is the formula? 2A plus ND into 2N Cn whole divided by 2. Or what is it? How to remember? The arithmetic mean of first coefficient and last coefficient into 2N Cn. Correct? Here what is N value? 15. Okay, so arithmetic mean of first and last means 1 plus 31 by 2. Okay, arithmetic mean of first coefficient and last coefficient, that is 1 plus 31 by 2 into 2n cn. What is n value? 15. So 2n cn means what? 2n value 30, c n value 15. So 1 plus 31 by 2 is 32 by 2. 32 by 2 is 16. 16 into 30 c 15. 16 into 30 c 15. That was the answer. So look at one more important result. MC0 into NCR plus MC1 into NCR minus 1 and so on. MCR into NC0. If you observe M terms, subscripts, what we have in a 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on are. That means those subscripts are increasing. If you observe N terms, subscripts are R, R minus 1, R minus 2 and so on 0. That means those subscripts are decreased by 1 from term to term. But in every term, the sum of the subscripts is same. The sum of the subscripts is same. What is the sum of these subscripts? R only, no? Sum of these subscripts. R, 0 plus R, R. This is a 1 plus R minus 1, R. 2 plus R minus 2, R. R plus 0, R. So in the answer also what you will get? R. But what you will get top? Adding these two tops. Adding those two tops. So answer is M plus N CR. Answer is M plus N CR. Okay. So this problem can be done in two different ways. The first way is, suppose there are in a class there are M boys are there. M boys, N girls. M boys and N girls are there. That means total number of students. How many students are there? M plus N students. And in how many ways you can choose R students? In how many ways you can choose R students? So one of the way is M plus N CR. Another way is, So you have to choose how many students are students. You can choose 0 boys or girls. Correct? So which can be done how many ways? MCA0 into NCR ways. Or means plus. You can choose 1 boy or minus 1 girls. So this second choice can be done in how many ways? MC1 into NCR minus 1. That is the second term. Or R means plus. You can choose 2 boys or minus 2 girls. So that can be done in how many ways? MC2 into NCR minus 2. And so on. You can choose R boys, 0 girls. That can be done in how many ways? MCR into NC0. That is the last term. That means this whole sum is same as what? M plus N into CR. This is the one way. Okay? One method to prove. Okay? Another method is you consider the product of 1 plus x whole power m into x plus 1 whole power n. Product of 1 plus x whole power m into x plus 1 whole power n. Okay? So expand 1 plus x whole power n and expand x plus 1 whole power n. Okay? So now in both sides you equate coefficient of x power r. Okay? Both sides you equate coefficient of x power r. In RHS product, the coefficient of x power r becomes this LHS of the series. This LHS. That is MC0 into NCR plus MC1 into NCR minus 1 and so on. MCR into NC0. In this LHS, 1 plus x whole power m into x plus 1 whole power n is same as 1 plus x whole power m plus n. Am I correct? Now, in this expansion of this binomial, what is the coefficient of x power r? M plus NCR. Okay? So that means in this product, the coefficient of x power r is this LHS. In this LHS, the coefficient of x power r is RHS of this. So thus, m plus n CR value is same as this. Or this series, whole series is equal to what? M plus n CR. But how you have to remember? In each term, sum of the subscripts is constant. One is begin with 0, another one is begin with r and end with ulta. So whichever begin with 0, end with r, whichever begin with r, end with 0. Okay, so for example, the question is suppose 10C0 into 15C4 plus 10C1 into 15C3 plus 10C2 into 15C2 plus 10C3 into 15C1 plus 10C4 into 15C0. So what is the answer for this? What is the answer for this series? Observe, in each term, sum of the subscripts is 4 constant. Correct? And one is begin with 0, end with 4. Another one is begin with 4, end with 0. So that sum is constant. So what is that constant? 4. And what do you get top? Adding this m and n. 10 plus 15, how much? 25. So this whole sum is equal to how much? 25C4. So you consider one more example. Suppose 15C0 into 20C10 plus 15C1 into 20C9 plus 15C2 into 20C18. 18 alla 8. Plus and so on. 15C10 into 20C0. So tell me now what you will get the answer. 15 plus 20, how much? 35. C, sum of the subscripts, what? 0 plus 10? 10. Because in each term, sum of the subscript is the same, 10. 0 plus 10, 10. 1 plus 9, 10. 2 plus 8, 10. 10 plus 0, 10. So the answer will be 15 plus 20, 35. 0 plus 10, 10. 35C10. That was the answer. 35C10 is the answer. So, with this, I'm going to close this session. I hope you understand these problems. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and ask them subscribe my channel to get more number of videos. Thank you.